Hi friends, in last class we discussed about quantum theory for Raman scattering. In this class we are going to discuss about classical theory of Raman scattering. We know that consider a capacitor. This will be connected to positive and this will be connected to negative. Here there is a dielectric medium. When we connect the capacitor to positive terminal, it becomes positive, and the other way which is connected to negative terminal becomes negative. Because of this electric field, there will be polarization of the molecules in that dielectric medium. Here it becomes minus and here it is plus. Similarly, these molecules and the final molecule become plus and minus. This is nothing but polarization. There is induced dipole moment in the molecule because of apply of electric field. Here we are applying electric field which is static electric field, that is time independent electric field is nothing but static electric field. Because of this static electric field, there is dipole moment. Which dipole moment? Induced dipole moment in the molecule, that is nothing but polarization. Similarly, in Raman scattering, we see that we are supplying visible light, and in visible light, that is electromagnetic light, we have electric field and magnetic field. But here the electric field is time dependent, that is, it is not the independent of time, it is time dependent, hence it is not static, it is time varying electric field. Since in radiation we have time varying electric field, so the molecule which we are going to study is going to be polarized by the effect of this, by the effect of this electric field, the molecule is going to polarize. So we write the equation such that, see, there is induced dipole movement due to apply of electric field. But here the electric field is nothing but radiation, because it has time dependent electric field. And we know that to remove this proportionality constant, we put another constant, say mu is equal to alpha E, where E is time dependent electric field, that is radiation, time dependent, whereas mu is dipole movement, induced dipole movement due to polarizability, and this is constant, and this is known as polarizability, that is polarizability, that is due to apply of this, the molecule is going to get polarized, that is the ease with which the molecule get polarized is nothing but polarizability. So we got the expression mu is equal to alpha E, where alpha is polarizability and E is time varying electric field, and mu is induced dipole movement in the molecule. We know that since our radiation is electromagnetic, it contains electric field, and it is given by the equation E is equal to E naught sin 2 pi mu t. I told this is time dependent, so we have t here. This equation represents the electric field is time dependent, and E naught is the amplitude of that wave. This is E naught amplitude, and it is time dependent, and mu is the frequency of that radiation. So we got this expression, and we are going to substitute this in this equation. So we got mu is equal to alpha E is nothing but E naught sin 2 pi mu t. As I told, when we apply this electric field to the molecule, it is going to get polarized. That is, the equation for polarizing, that is alpha, is given by alpha is equal to alpha naught plus dou alpha upon dou q sin 2 pi. by mu v into t. Here it is mu v. See, because we are supplying electromagnetic radiation and the molecule is going to get polarized. The molecule is going to get polarized. Since it is time-varying electric field, along with it, molecule experiences vibration. Hence, its frequency is given by mu v, that is vibrational frequency. Here, alpha is the polarizability and alpha naught is a constant, like amplitude. And dou alpha upon dou q, this represent the rate of change of polarizability with respect to coordinate. That is, dou alpha upon dou q is nothing but rate of change of polarizability with respect to coordinate. And mu v is because of vibration, it expresses vibration. Hence, I substitute this equation in this equation. I had this equation and I substitute this in this, I got this equation. And now I am going to substitute value of alpha in this equation. So I will get, see, I can write mu is equal to, see, mu is equal to alpha is nothing but alpha naught. I substitute this value in this, alpha naught plus dou alpha upon dou q sine 2 pi mu p t the whole into E naught, that is E naught sine 2 pi mu t. This is the expression I got. Now I can multiply. So I will get mu is equal to alpha naught into E naught, that is alpha naught E naught sine 2 pi mu t plus E naught into dou alpha upon dou q into sine 2 pi mu t into sine 2 pi mu v times of t. I got this expression. Now I will do, just I divide this expression by 2 and I multiply this by 2. 2 to get the answer, I get the same expression. I just divided this term by 2 and I multiply by 2. Now I apply mathematical formula. 2, this is nothing but 2 sine A into sine B. And we know that 2 sine A into sine B is nothing but cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. Now I apply that for this expression and I am going to get mu is equal to this inverse constant, that is alpha naught E naught sine 2 pi mu t plus this, I am going to take common E naught upon 2 dou alpha upon dou q, and this expression becomes cos A, that is, let me write 2 pi mu minus mu v times of t minus of cos 2 pi mu plus mu v times of t. I got this expression. Now I simplify, that is mu is equal to, that is alpha naught E naught sine 2 pi mu t plus, just I multiply all terms, E naught upon 2 dou alpha upon dou q into cos 2 pi mu minus mu v times of t minus of E naught upon 2 E naught upon 2 dou alpha upon dou q upon dou q into this term cos 2 pi mu plus mu v upon t. This is the final expression I got after substituting and considering the all the equations. From this equation, let me write this be the first term and this be the second term and this be the third term. Now I am going to rub the previous derivations. Yesterday we discussed that, see, if this is the molecule and we are going to supply visible light, when we see from perpendicular to that incident light, we get some of the scattered light which are having some lines having frequency equal to that of incident light, some are having greater than that of incident light, and some are having smaller than that of incident light. See from this expression also we can see all those lines. See, alpha naught d naught sine 2 pi mu into t. For derivation we supplied the light which is having frequency mu and we got the mu only. That is, the supplied is nothing but the supplied frequency and the scattered frequency both are same, and this line is known as Rayleigh line. This is due to elastic scattering, and the second term from this expression we can see that there is mu minus of mu v, that is there is decrease in frequency, and if the frequency decreases, those lines are called Stokes lines, and it is due to inelastic scattering. This is Stokes lines. And the third term, we can see that mu plus mu v, that is there is addition, that is there is increase in frequency. Hence, this type of lines are called as anti-Stokes lines, and it is also due to inelastic scattering. And these two lines are nothing but Raman lines, and this is Rayleigh line. This is the expression for classical theory of Raman scattering. Now I need to tell, consider if we have supplied the radiation and there is no change in polarizability of the molecule. If there is no change in the polarizability of the molecule, then dou alpha upon dou q, that is rate of change of polarizability with respect to coordinate, will be 0. If this is the case, then see, the third term will become 0 and the second term will also become 0 because dou alpha upon dou q is 0. Hence, these two terms become 0 and we are left with only this term. Mu is equal to, that is induced dipole moment is equal to alpha naught E naught sine 2 pi mu t. This is nothing but Rayleigh line. So, if you supply any radiation, if the molecule is not going to get polarized, then the light will scatter and gives us only Rayleigh scattering, and the line will be Rayleigh line. If the molecule exhibit polarizability, then only we are going to get these lines, that is Stokes lines and anti-Stokes lines. If you ask me how to make this term zero, we can make this term zero only when if we don't supply any radiation. If we don't supply any radiation, then it will be not having any frequency, then this term becomes zero. From these expressions, it is significantly known that if we supply radiation, there will be scattering, and scattering contains which kind of scattering? Elastic scattering, it contains Rayleigh lines. If the molecules exhibit polarizability, then only we are going to get Stokes lines and anti-Stokes lines. From this, it is clear that Raman scattering is helpful only when the molecule will have polarizability. And in our previous classes, that is in rotational spectroscopy and vibrational spectroscopy, we came to know that the molecules like H2, O2, N2 and Cl2 etc. we can't determine its bond length and other parameters. So these lines were called as IR, infrared inactive, and also microwave inactive, because they don't have any permanent dipole. But when we supply visible light to such molecules, let me just energy the nucleus, which is having control over the electrons, was lost for a momentary. So the molecule get polarized. Because of this polarization, we can determine the spectrum for H2O2 into CO2 like molecules, that is homodinuclear molecules. So the Raman, so hence in Raman spectroscopy, these molecules are Raman active, that is vibrational Raman active. That is, from Raman spectroscopy we can determine the bond length of this molecule and also the force constant and other parameter of these molecules. Hence these molecules are known as vibrational Raman active. Because of that radiation, there will be polarization in these molecules. Why polarization? Because the energy is very high, because we are supplying visible light, the energy is very high. For a momentary, the nucleus will lose the hold on electrons. Because of that, there will be polarization in the molecule, and these are known as vibrational Raman active molecules. Whereas in IR and microwaves, these molecules were inactive. This is the advantage of Raman spectroscopy over visual spectroscopy. And this is about classical theory of Raman scattering, and we got the equation, and I have explained the significance of this equation, and I also have explained how to make these terms zero. And from this it is clear that, see, if scattering occurs, there should be Rayleigh scattering. If the molecule exhibit polarizability, then only these two lines occurs. So in general, we know that in 1 million we have only 1 or 2 these lines, that is Stokes line and anti-Stokes line. Remaining all are Rayleigh lines. So the intensity of these lines will be less. To increase this intensity, there is an advancement in Raman spectroscopy, that is SERS, surface enhancer Raman spectroscopy, which we will learn in further classes. This is about classical theory of Raman scattering. Now we are going to discuss about pure rotational Raman spectroscopy spectrum, that is for, and it is only for diatomic molecule. Pure Raman spectrum, that is pure rotational Raman spectrum for diatomic molecules. Pure rotational, pure rotational Raman spectrum for diatomic molecules like H2N2, O2, HCl, CO2, all it is applicable for all these molecules. See, pure rotational Raman spectrum for diatomic molecules. From rotational spectroscopy, we know that the energy of rotation in terms of wave number is given by B into J into J plus 1. And the selection rule in Raman spectroscopy is delta J is equal to 0 or plus or minus 2, plus for absorption and minus for emission, and 0 is for Rayleigh scattering, that is Rayleigh lines, and plus or minus 2 is for Stokes and anti-Stokes lines, anti-Stokes lines. That is, delta J is the selection rule for Raman spectrum, is delta J is equal to 0 for Rayleigh lines or plus or minus 2 for Stokes and anti-Stokes lines. Please note it down. Now, we know that if transition takes from J to J dash, then the change in wave number, that is delta mu bar, is nothing but B into higher, that is J dash, j dash plus 1 minus v into lower j into j plus 1. This is the transition. And we know that from selection rule delta j is equal to 0 or plus or minus 2. So let me consider delta j, that is j dash minus j is equal to plus 2. So I can write j dash is equal to j plus 2 from this equation. Hence I am going to substitute this equation in this. So I will get delta mu bar is equal to b into j dash is nothing but j plus 2. Here also j dash plus 1. So j plus 2 plus 1, that is j plus 3. And here I will get b into j plus 1. Now I will multiply and I will simplify. Delta mu is equal to b into j dash. Nothing. I will take b for common first. And I am going to get j into j dash is nothing but j square. J into 3j, 2j, 5j plus 2 is a 6 minus j into j square and minus of j into 1 minus j. So I am left with delta mu bar is equal to v into j dash got cancelled minus j, that is 4j plus 6. This I got. If I consider delta j is equal to minus 2, here I consider delta j is equal to plus 2. That if I consider delta j is equal to minus 2, that is delta j is equal to j dash minus j is equal to minus 2. Then I can write j is equal to j dash plus 2. If I substitute this in same equation, that is 1, I substitute this also in 1. And now I am going to substitute this in same equation 1. Then I am going to get delta mu is equal to see b into j dash is same, j dash into j dash plus 1 minus b into j can be written as j dash plus 2 into c j dash, j is j dash plus 2 plus 1, that is j dash plus 3 I got. Now I can substitute, I can simplify by multiplying. Let me take b common and now I multiply j into j dash, that is j dash square plus j dash, here minus j into j dash square minus j into 3j dash, 2dz, that is minus 5j dash, and 2 into 3, 6 minus 6. If I simplify this, I am going to get delta wave number b into j dash square and this I got cancelled. And here I have with minus 4j dash minus 6. If I consider minus common, delta j dash equal to minus b into j dash plus 6. Let me write the equation delta mu is equal to b into 4j plus 6 b, equation 2, and this b equation 3. Now I am going to rub all these terms to simplify further. Let me rub all these terms. So I got c. From equation 2 and 3 I can write delta mu, c equation 2 and 3. Now from equation 2 and 3 I can directly write delta mu is equal to b into b, that is, sorry, delta mu is equal to, I can write plus or minus of b into 4j plus 6. From equation 2 and 3 I directly wrote delta mu is equal to plus or minus b into 4j plus 6. This is the final expression from 2 and 3. And we know that in Raman, mu is equal to wave number of incident plus or minus delta mu. So if I substitute this in equation this and should call it as equation 4, then I got mu is equal to mu I, that is incident frequency plus or minus b into 4j plus 6 plus or minus b into 4j plus 6. And we know that j is nothing but rotational quantum number, and j can have value j is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. That is, so if I substitute j is equal to 0, then I am going to get mu. This can also be written as delta mu, like that. No problem. This time this is different. No need to confuse. See, delta mu r is equal to mu r, that is incident frequency, plus or minus. I am substituting j is equal to 0. Let me write here, when j is equal to 0. Delta mu is equal to mu I plus or minus b, here that is 6b. I am left with 6b. And when j is equal to 1, delta mu bar is equal to mu I plus or minus 10b. See, if j is equal to 1, 4 on the 4, 6 plus 4, 10, so I got plus or minus 10b. If j is equal to 2, delta mu bar is equal to mu I plus or minus, substitute 2, 4 to the a plus 6, that is 14b. And I can separate this term also as delta mu is equal to mu I plus 6b or mu I minus 6b. Hence I can plot a graph. Let me consider this is the increasing order of wave number, like this period wave number, and it is increasing like this. Let me consider when j is equal to 0, let me consider this PA incident frequency, and it is also known as Raman scattering, that is mu I. For Raman scattering, mu I incident frequency, it is frequency. Incident frequency and scattered frequency both are same. So it is mu I for Raman lines. So see, mu I is for Raman lines, and when j is equal to 0, it is plus or minus 6. Plus means this side, minus means this side. Let me draw this b. Plus or minus 6. Mu I plus or minus 6. So it is 6b. That is 6b. And here, with the same distance, let me write it is minus 6b. Mu I minus 6b. Further, I got mu 1 plus or minus 10b. From this it is 10b, but from this it is 10 minus 6 is 4b. So I am going to get one more line, and it is, the distance is 4b, but from here it is 10b. 6b plus 4b is nothing but 10b. Mu 1 plus 10b. Similarly here I am going to get, this is minus 10b. Mu 1 minus 10b. Similarly, next I got 14. That is 10 plus 4 is 14. But the intensity will be more, and the distance remains constant, 4b. And here also I got 4b. Further, if I keep on increasing j value, I am going to get a graph like this. Similarly, here this is increasing wave number, and here these are equally spaced, that is delta 4b, 4b, all are 4b, and here also all are 4b, but initially it is 6b, and further it will be 4b. Why? Because of this expression. See, initially we got 6b, further 10b, there is increase of 4, then also increase of 4, 14b, next it will be 18b. See, that j is equal to 3. If you substitute j is equal to 3, 4 is 12, 12 plus 6 is nothing but 18. So we got 18b. Further, it will be 22b. There will be equally spaced here, but here it is not equal spaced. Here it is 6b, further it is 4b, 4b. And the intensity is like this. Because in our previous classes I told when J-value increases, the intensity will decreases. Initially intensity will be low. As J-value increases, there will be increase in intensity. Further increase in J-value, there will be decrease in intensity. That is J versus intensity, we get a graph like that. Because of that, we get a spectrum like this. This is about pure rotational spectrum in Raman, that is pure rotational Raman spectrum for diatomic molecule. In next class, we are going to study about rotational vibration spectroscopy in Raman, that is Raman spectroscopy. Till then, see you. Bye.